Guys, if you haven't already, make sure to follow the podcast on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. It helps us more than you could imagine.
That was a serious little slurp you had there, lad. Give it another one. I would say that noise mixed in with people eating with their mouth open are two of the most disgusting things.
Now, you see, when I hear this drink noise, it makes me want a drink.
Right.
People eating with the mouth open, that's just disgusting, you know.
You ever been on a date, chick eating with the mouth open?
No, I don't think I have. You have.
Yeah, I have. Usually after dinner, you go, oh, let's go for some
Tell
drinks and see where the night
worst,
leads us.
Tell me about your worst ever date. Don't have to name drop, and you can make
it. Okay.
I'll
talk about it. But what I'm trying to say is I don't actually have a terrible, like, I don't have the nightmare date.
Nothing too crazy.
What I had one particular date that stands out in my mind. Went out for dinner. She was sort of like eating with her mouth open. But the worst part was her manners towards the staff.
Oh no.
And it really put me off. There was no thank yous. And just in general, we just get bad vibes from someone with the way she was chatting to people, and even just like chatting about people. I was there like, I can't wait for this dinner to be over. I'm heading home. And yeah, like the classic excuse, I got film in early doors, so you're gonna have to.
There's nothing worse than someone that is rude to like bartenders.
I hate people like that.
Restaurant
like,
staff. Like, it's just
have some respect.
Like they're better than them. Like, oh, it's just like, fuck me, they're doing a job.
Yeah, like literally just they're like doing they're job. Getting and look, it, you know, sometimes you do get a bad waiter, you get bad service or whatever, but just don't be a dick. Like, who cares? Like, who cares, you know? Like, now it's funny because we've got quite a few friends that would never complain. And I will complain at a place if I think something has been poor or, you know, they've done me over. Or, you know, if my food's not right, I'll say, like, look, I asked for a medium rare steak. This is like almost well done. Like, I have no problem saying that, but like I'll do it in a very polite way. Mm-hmm. I'm not there like, this is bang out of order, blah, 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 blah. The other day I was at a bar. You were there as well.
I was with you, yeah.
Okay, so we're not going to name this place. It's a popular place in London, a chain. And we waited over an hour for drinks, right? And I went down around like the 40 minute mark.
It was
and
cold.
I said, guys, where's this drink? We waited 40 minutes and the guy was insisting. He's like, it's coming. I'm really sorry. Anyways, I go back upstairs, still nothing. An hour later, I came down, and I'll admit, like, I was literally there like, guys, you guys are really like, this is terrible. Like, I was literally like, this is really bad. And the guy behind the bartender tried to almost he didn't even say sorry. He said, look around, it's been really busy tonight, like it's slow. And I look around, mate, the place is at 50% capacity. It's not big. And I get, look, and if he was being overworked, if they didn't have enough bar staff or whatever, that's completely fine.
But I remember seeing there was not that many people,
but we didn't even get like they didn't even go, oh, we're really sorry about this, you know, here's a couple of free drinks or whatever it is. They didn't even try and make it up. They were just kept telling us it's coming.
That was the annoying bit.
I'm like, bro, it's been an hour since we ordered drinks.
Maybe they were understaffed possibly, but they should have just said, doesn't take an
hour.
Doesn't take over an hour to pull some pints.
Or we got it completely wrong. That's our bad. Yeah. You know, just say something. And he said, I feel like such a dick having to go up to, because I don't want to have to go up to you and be annoyed.
Yeah.
But ultimately we had like, you know, a group of six waiting upstairs for an hour. An hour for some drinks. I was fuming. It's not cheap. That particular came to like 160 quid worth of drinks.
Well, the thing was as well, like we ordered and then the bar closed because it took so long we couldn't get our next up. So we only got to have one drink.
So we had a drink.
Alien. Yeah, it was not.
Like what?
Anyway, so. But it happens.
But anyway, sorry. That was my worst date was just someone being really rude and just unnecessary. It was just unnecessary. There was nothing wrong with the service. There was nothing wrong with the food. They just had no manners.
I've had one where she kept going on about Rosa Shaw.
Sorry, what?
Yep. She just kept talking about Harry. I was just like,
we're going. I need a little story time here, bro. You just dropped that like it was nothing.
Yeah, she just kept talking about it. She's like, what's Harry like? All this kind of shit. And I'm
what's
just like,
Harry like?
What's Harry like? I'm on this date with this girl, and she's just like, so you're friends with, I know, obviously, you're friends with YouTubers, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, yeah of course. And she says, well, what's Harry like? And I'm like, well, he's a nice guy. He's great. He's my friend. And she's like, so what's it like being friends with him? I was like,
oh my God, what the hell?
And I'm just thinking to myself, I don't know what it's like friends being friends with your friends, like, you know.
Yeah.
It's quite the normal experience.
Yeah.
But she just, and then it got about normal again. I was like, okay, I'll let, you know, she's probably just curious because she's such a big, she's probably a fan a little bit, whatever. Yeah. A couple of 30 minutes passed by, straight back onto it. I got a friend that went on a date with Harry. And I'd be like, oh, please, like, I just don't, I'm, you know, I don't care.
Yeah. Please just please, stop.
Just stop. Let's talk about fucking anything, you know? What's your favorite flower?
Yeah, fucking anything's better than you talking about your
favorite type of fucking wood.
Yeah, you're like
oak, you're like mahogany. No, she wants to talk straight rotosho. That's her favorite type of wood.
And so what were you saying? Were you just there like...
I was just thinking to myself, why am I...
Okay, you were there like, so what happened? You did it and you just cut? You
why am I? No.
Jim, you talk.
Listen, Bella.
Listen, it is what it is.
I took a sacrifice.
Yeah. That is so funny,
I did
man.
It for all the boys out
that
there.
That is so funny, man. Fucking hell. I couldn't imagine Harry. That. Imagine going on a date and then they're just like, so what's your best friend like?
Yeah, what's what like? What is that? Tell me all about it.
You know, this. Oh,
I'm just
my
sat
God.
There thinking, why? I need more subs, man.
Yeah. Oh, no, you just, I need more drinks.
Yeah, I need more drinks. I need a mil on Instagram. She's obviously not happy with this.
You got a verified tick on Insta?
I do. To be fair, my Instagram's not bad. It's only like it's a platform of mine that I don't have a problem growing with because I use it the most.
Yeah, I like Instagram. Don't the use thing Twitter. Is, I don't get like. Does anyone else? It's weird because, you know, it's my job, isn't it? I need to be posting on Instagram all the time. They're like that. I don't see Instagram like that. I never think, I haven't posted in a week. I need to post a picture. Like if you look at my I won't post a picture on there for like a month and then I'll have like 3 days where I post them back to back to back.
Yeah, me and you're the same. My last post was Ollieball.
Yeah, it's just
ages ago.
But you know, I've heard that it like I'm gonna say that this is gonna sound weird, but like normal people that aren't their job isn't got anything to do with social media, they're thinking I haven't posted in a week. I need to post on Instagram.
Really?
And it's like why?
No,
why do you need to post on Instagram?
I don't have anything to post, and every time I look at a picture, I'm like, I look too clapped there for Instagram, so I never post it.
Yeah.
Crazy.
It's just weird to me that people are thinking, that have their job is not social media, nothing, but they're thinking, oh, it's been a while since I posted on Instagram, I should do this. Like, why? Why do you need to post on Instagram?
Yeah, there's no fucking reason.
What's going on?
Gotta keep their engagement up.
You gotta keep their...
I mean, if your job was like, you know, doing like these, you know, small micro fucking influencer brands, then
I've heard
enough,
about these, yeah.
It's like people that maybe get paid like, you know, 100 quid for a post, or they'll get paid in products and stuff, so they'll keep it up because you don't want to lose that. And I mean, if you just started, to be fair, like, just so imagine you've got a normal job, or you know, you've got a job that is outside social media, like we said.
Yeah.
You know,
I'm working a 9-to-5, Chip.
Yeah, you're working a 9-to-5, okay? You know, it could be a Tesco, it could be a fucking bank, it could be a corporate job, anything. So, and then you got the opportunity to maybe post on Instagram twice a week and get £100 per post. You're gonna do it, right?
Oh, 100%.
Yeah, and so you're like, wow, I'm making an extra 200 quid a week. I'm making an extra £800 a month.
That is really good.
I guess in their minds, they're like, oh, I don't want my engagement to go down. If I'm getting 500 to 1,000 likes or whatever.
Yeah.
If I got post
a month. How many likes do you reckon you need to be paid for your Instagram post?
I think maybe 1,000 plus, maybe.
Yeah, I'm thinking, because I've heard about this term like micro influencers.
Yeah.
And it sounds really weird and like, it sounds like.
Micro influencer, anyone less than, anyone maybe like around 50K? Like
anything less 50 than 50K, 100? Is that about right?
No, I think maybe micro
maybe
might
less?
Be like 50 to 100.
No, bro, no. I think there are people with like 10K followers getting paid for posts.
Really?
I'm not even messing
with
you.
Yeah, well, to be fair, if they've got a good engagement and get good impressions, then it makes sense for
Alex is saying that there's people with 2K followers getting paid
really?
For posts.
Really? But I guess it would depend on your impressions.
So they get paid in product and stuff, which is always a bit of a finesse, by the way. Be careful with that.
But like, obviously, if you've got less than 2K followers and getting paid in products, you're probably more than happy with that.
Yeah,
because it's not your job. You've got your own job.
Yeah.
All this is you've gone and taken a picture.
Side
and
hustle.
Free products for it.
Yeah, no.
Especially
it's true.
If it's like makeup and you love a bit of makeup, or you know, fucking free pair of trainers.